Welcome to the Kalyani Business Lounge, Zambezi Airlines.
Okay, well, my name is Don McDonald, and I'm the Chief Executive of Zambezi Airlines. The airline has been around in Zambia just for a short time. It started about 2 years ago as a domestic carrier, and last year we moved from domestic into regional flying to the surrounding countries. That was part of our longer-term strategy, which is now that we look at connecting up the various countries in the SADC region, in the Southern Africa Development Community region. And we believe there's a real niche in the market for this, because Africa, as many of you are aware, is an area where we have quite a lot of challenges in terms of logistics, in terms of traveling, and in terms of transporting goods and services. So air services are the obvious way in which to get people and goods from one part of the region to another. And I believe personally that an efficient and affordable air service within the region, if you like, the southern part of Africa, is something that is absolutely necessary in order to see the countries and the people of this area trading and developing their own way out of poverty and out of economic difficulties. I therefore think it's incredibly important that we have an airline that is based in the region and serves the region. We don't have ambitions to start flying intercontinentally to the Far East or to America or such destinations, but rather than competing with some of the big boys like South African Airways or Kenya Airways, which are already serving Africa in these markets, we wanted to place ourselves, if you like, in the middle between Nairobi and Johannesburg, which are the two big hubs in the continent, and we wanted to look at ways of just connecting surrounding countries, being able to bring them into Lusaka and connect them to each other, but also connect them to Johannesburg and to Nairobi, and of course onto the world beyond. The reason that we chose the title Zambezi, or the name Zambezi, is because the Zambezi is actually, as you know, a river that flows through several of the countries in the SADC region. And yes, we could have called it a Zambian company or a Zambian airline, and that would have been correct, because we are a Zambian airline and we are proud of that. But we wanted to make the point that we were serving a number of countries rather than just being focused on one particular country in the region. So the Zambezi River touches a large number of the countries that we service, and that's exactly what we wanted to convey in the name, is that we touch these countries as well, connect with them and connect them to each other. In terms of the logo and the colors, they're very interesting colors, I think. They are the colors of the Thornycroft giraffe, the markings that you will find on a giraffe. Now, Thornycroft giraffe is a species of giraffe that is unique to Zambia. It's not found anywhere else in the world. It's found in the Luangwa Valley, and it has a different marking from the, if I might call, the regular giraffe, and this is why we've chosen those colors to represent Africa, to represent Zambia, and also to represent something that we believe is unique. So that's how we got our name, and that's how we got our colors. And we've now been flying regionally just less than a year, but we've noticed that there's a huge demand for people to get from Lusaka to Johannesburg, from Dar es Salaam, from Nairobi, and so on. And as I said, rather than directing people through Nairobi or Johannesburg to reach their destination, we thought Lusaka is very geographically well positioned within Southern Africa to be a hub for all the connecting points. So ultimately we would like to see ourselves being able to fly people from Dar es Salaam through to Windhoek in Namibia, for example. We'd like to be able to connect east and west and north south. And I think that if we can look at that and we have a strategy in that sense, that we don't try to compete with what other people are doing, but we look at finding ways of bringing people together and making it easier for them to reach where they want to be and to communicate with each other, we believe that we will have a successful business model. But just as importantly, we believe we'll be playing a very significant part in developing the region and developing the people within the region to be in a situation where they begin to stand on their feet and trade for themselves, amongst themselves, between themselves, and begin to develop their country and their infrastructure themselves. Currently, we operate two 737-500 aircraft, Boeing aircraft, and we chose the 500 because it's a newer generation of aircraft. It's more fuel efficient than some of the older ones, and also it gives a very good service. For those who know and who have traveled within Africa, you'll know that the 737 series is the kind of workhorse of the continent here. The market does know these aircraft and likes them. We moved up from the older models to the 500 model in order to give a higher quality of service, and this has worked very well for us. We have aircraft that we believe can compete just as well as any that are flying around the region. We also have plans to bring in a third aircraft, which will be in 3 months' time, and that will give us the opportunity now to look at further extending our routes and our connections within the region. Currently, we use our aircraft to fly to Dar es Salaam and to Johannesburg from Lusaka in Zambia, and also from Indola in Zambia, which is further north in the Copper Belt area. And once we have a third aircraft, that will allow us to begin to look at expanding into surrounding countries such as Zimbabwe. We're hoping to commence flights from Harare, connecting into our existing network. We're looking at connecting into Lilongwe in Malawi, which is just our next door neighbor as far as countries are concerned. And we'd also like to be able to connect them to Dar es Salaam and to all the other destinations we go to. And then I think we'd be looking a little bit further afield and maybe getting into conversations with our colleagues in Namibia or Botswana or Angola, seeing what we can do to connect up these capital cities in these countries to our network and begin to tie everybody in together so that they are able to reach where they want to go. The biggest project we're facing at the moment, right, is to tie in with Kenya Airways. Now, Kenya Airways is one of the big operators as far as Africa is concerned, a very, very successful company and doing very well in terms of serving all of us in Africa. We would like to see a situation where we can fly into Nairobi and carry passengers for Kenya Airways into Nairobi, then allow them to change at Nairobi to go to any of the destinations that they want to go to. And in fact, we have already signed an agreement with them which will allow us to start flying into Nairobi by the end of this month and be able to ticket people all the way through to destinations such as London and Amsterdam, Paris in Europe. And also in the Far East, we're looking at very popular destinations like Guangzhou in China, Hong Kong, Bangkok, Mumbai, and all of these are coming on stream in the next month or so. And that, you know, it makes life very challenging for us here in the management, but we're very happy to be able to say that we're growing and getting these new destinations available through Zambezi Airlines. From the beginning of the company flying, we wanted to make world-class service with an African touch. That was the sort of vision we had, and we've been working hard on that. We get a lot of very good and positive feedback about our cabin service and our in-flight service, and obviously we pay a lot of attention to the other areas as well, including technical safety, maintenance, and so on. But certainly we have a product we are proud of, and we hope that all of you who've tried flying with us have enjoyed the product. And those of you who haven't flown with us, we hope that you do soon.
and gentlemen, the aircraft doors are now closed. May we kindly request that you switch all cellular telephones off now. Thank you. Cabin crew, arm your doors and cross check.
Left and one right, descend and cross checked.
Thank you for choosing to fly Zambezi Airlines. Bye-bye.